Good morning. Stop here in Delta on Nordell Way? Yeah, that's Nordell Way, right? Yeah, Nordell Way. Now we have to head to Richmond to get loaded. It is 6:30 in the morning, plus 9 degrees Celsius on this beautiful April 21st. I took the microphone all the way apart, put it all the way back together. I tugged and pinched it in places and I'm in the wrong way. Tugged and put it all back together and hopefully that fixed the static. I don't know. I did a test on it and the static was fixed on the test. I have just gridlocked. Hopefully we get a green light before our light goes red. Okay, there's about 10 cars beside me too. So I'm not the only one gridlocking, but still. Our light just went yellow and this one went green. Perfect. Yellow. No traffic jam here today morning, that is nice. Okay, a little bit. Sun is just coming up. I woke up way too early, so I didn't get enough sleep. I don't know what woke me up. Something woke me up and I couldn't go back to sleep, so. But seeing I've been getting up at 4, I guess maybe I just woke up naturally earlier. I mean, I still got like 6.5, 7 hours, something like that. Yeah, probably closer to 7 hours. My goal is to get full 8. Yeah, I woke up an hour earlier than that, my alarm, so yeah. Yeah.
Take the man on the back road to Highway 91 north toward Denver.
I used it? This used to be one lane not that long ago, so. Now there's two of our turning lanes. Should only take about 15 minutes to get to our customer. Gotta make sure I'm in the right lanes to make all these turns. They've got a red light. Hopefully they build an overpass here as well. I mean, there's a bunch of construction materials here, but is that for an overpass here, or is that just for the construction site down on Highway 17? Traffic jam here onto the bridge. Driving a short distance just to work or something, it might be fine. You wouldn't want to do long distance unless you have heated gear. sure I picked the right lane. Yes, okay, good, good, good. Oh, it just went yellow. Sometimes you're looking in the mirror, you look back up, and it's like, it's changed colors. So you guys probably knew it changed colors before I did, because I was looking in the mirrors. This is the Westminster Highway, right beside Highway 91? I can't remember the highway number. I think it's 91. It's gotta be 91. That they finally four-lane this section through the railroad here. Thank you, sir. He saw me slowing down, he just flashed his brights at me and said, oh, okay, you are leaving space for me. I will not slow down. Without even having to signal. Both lanes turn. Both lanes turn. Excuse me. Sorry. First one of the day. Just for you guys. Just look at the bobtail beside us. He's got square fuel tanks. Carry a lot more fuel in a tank like that. Forward. So Mine didn't. Cars by. Like, I know the lane ends, but I can get the cars all by me. No queuing on Nelson Road, which would be this road right here, so we can't line up in a queue on this road. Oh, they've put in the red light on this corner. It used to be a four-way stop. Chaos. It was chaos. That's what it was. Red light. No more chaos. Coming here last night, I'm like, I bet you the gates will all be closed and I can't get in here. Because you could totally sleep over here. Speed bump hidden here that you think, hey, it's just a speed bump. Nope. Hit that at anything more than 10 kilometers per hour, you get launched. Behind us, no train in front of us. Stop to double check. Wow. I almost got launched off my seat. Good thing I got a seatbelt. And they've paved this, so a lot less of this black dust flying around. Our chipper All right.
I think we're gonna line up for exit that way, but this is narrow. Pretty steep too. Really see if someone's coming, so we're just gonna go real slow. There is someone coming. Welcome to Aldergrove. Sorry, we're not actually going through town. Let's go north and get to Highway 1. Got our second load on. It's 20 degrees Celsius out here already. Nine o'clock in the morning? Yeah, 9 o'clock. Got a full trailer of concrete blocks and then these wooden cages of concrete rocks, different blocks, different shapes. So basically they're all concrete blocks, but some of them are funky little shapes that they had to throw them into these wooden cages. Rush over here. There's lots of trucks. second now. Oh, down there it is. It's looking up top. scale's open today in Hope. Well, call this the Laidlaw scale. Says 30, so the empty trucks can zoom by at 30 kilometers per hour. I always feel 30 is a little quick, so I usually go 20. Light load, 5,000 on the steers, 13 on the drives, and 17 on the trailer. It's a unique looking load. Environment. mats are designed so that all the heavy equipment dries on top of the mats instead of in the mud and dirt. Does all the damage to the ground and the vegetation. But I always find it's a little ironic that to do so, we cut down millions of trees. Looks like they're paving a road in the center there. Does that mean they're going to tear up this lane? Oh, is the pipeline going to go underneath this road? Because there is an existing pipeline here. Are they building a temporary road over there and they're going to build the new pipeline underneath this road? We'll find out, but that's my guess. heavy enough that we'll be slow going over the mountains. We can put another 6,000 kilograms on the trailer and another 4,000 kilogram on the truck. Well, not quite. It's a little more. We have a little more than that, but basically, we could take another 10,000 kilogram, well, 9,000 kilogram. I hope all these colors translate into the YouTubes, because the way the sun's hitting all these trees and all these that were naked over winter are now this yellowish green to them. Mountains in the background, just such a gorgeous day. Probably said that a couple times. I definitely love my job. legs and everything start popping. It'd be cool. Gotta be careful when you climb to the top of a pass. Make yourself a lunch. You open up the barbecue sauce bottle. All of a sudden it blows up and spews barbecue sauce on everything because there's so much pressure inside of it. Gotta be careful. Never had a bag of chips blow up over these passes. It was in California where we drove over a pass just with our personal vehicle on vacation where we had bags of chips blowing up. Also, all our cubed ice turned into just slush because all the little air bubbles inside the ice blew up. Now these passes, you can always see a bag of chips is just completely round and bloated like someone took an air compressor to it. And listen to our audio. Okay, Garmin. Let's reset you. Garmin thinks we're way off the road. I listened to the audio and I figured this out. Lots of static. Can I do that? No static. Lots of static. No static. At least a lot less static. And look. Lots of static. So, whatever happened to the microphone, it's picking up a lot more electricity than it used to do. It's picking up interference now. I should experiment in moving the microphone. That's the difference, isn't it? The microphone's on the center console, and it used to be off to my right beside the window. I'll have to do that test. He's like, are you not figured out yet? You're good. Good? Okay. Every now and then, the GPS does that. It's like, you're off-roading. It's like, no, I'm not. It's the power supply to the camera.
run off a battery, no static. Plug the power into the camera, lots of static. So if this works, I just have to make sure the camera is charged all the time, and then basically keep the camera plugged in when I'm not using it, unplug it when I'm recording. Easy peasy. I think a battery usually lasts about an hour or so if I have it all the way charged, so. Most of my clips are 10 to 15 minutes long. Behind me that as we were doing the corner to do the merge. I have to trust the other people not to pass me there. Having said that, I am doing my due diligence and checking the mirrors before I get into that corner. But sometimes a car catches up with you tremendously fast, and right now I had a car right on my bumper going into that corner. So there's a chance that they would have merged in there. So I start signaling way earlier when I see there's a car right back, right behind me, to let them know, hey, I'm about to take that lane. Maybe you shouldn't.
something else in delivery first, I could sleep on site. But once again, if I did the Nelson delivery first, I'd have to drive all the way down to trail, do the second delivery there, and then drive almost all the way back to Nelson to pick up my load. More efficient to deliver in trail first.
Fan.
definitely more clouds that direction. Towards the north, there's definitely more clouds. Yeah, there's definitely clouds moving in. Might just have those rain showers they're promising. It's 4 p.m. now, so at 23 degrees Celsius.
month or $4.99 a month. Guys, I'll get bonus videos. Should at least one a week. Usually release it. In fact, most of the time it's two bonus videos a week. And most of the time I release them on Saturday or Sunday. So if you want more videos, they're out there. You can have them for as little as 99 cents Canadian a month. It might be U.S. a month. It might be U.S. I'm not 100% sure on that. And of course, if you just want to do a lump sum, one-time donation type of thing, give me a dollar or five or whatever, you can always go on Patreon and just make a one-time donation and then discontinue your donations. Works as well. All the links are down below. If you guys become YouTube members, you guys get your own little icon. I see some of you guys are cyan already. Got some green and cyan commenters there, and it's pretty cool. So, super appreciate you guys. I'm out of here. I'm looking forward to reading your comments tomorrow morning.